coño.
Hey everybody, it's Andy Kushner, host of The Wedding Biz, and this is another episode of The Next Level. And I want to introduce my co-host. She is back from her incredible vacation. And if you message her on Instagram, she might just tell you where she went. It is Melissa Fancy.
Hi, everyone. Feeling refreshed over here.
Yes, refreshed. Are you going to admit where you were or going to leave that as a big mystery?
I will leave it a mystery. You can direct message me on Instagram and we'll talk all about it.
At Wedding Biz Show. How's that for a tease? Let's just say that she was somewhere where there was no Wi-Fi, right, Melissa? No Wi-Fi, no air conditioning. That's enough of a hint, right?
No Wi-Fi, no cell phone service, and no contact to the outside world.
Yeah, she was in her own dimension. So that's all we're going to say. So anyhow, together, Melissa and I are going to discuss the most recent guest interview, as we do every week on this show, and kind of pick out a few key topics and translate them into specific tactical strategies to bring your business to the next level. So other than your incredible vacation that I was not on, that you enjoyed thoroughly, what has been going on lately, Melissa?
Okay, you know what? I am loving your recent re-release of Brian Raffinelli, and I'm very excited because you are headed to New York to interview him for a part two. I would like to let everybody know this is your opportunity to ask Brian Raffinelli a question. I will post on Instagram and ask Brian little post, and you can leave your questions for him. Andy will draw one and ask Brian during the interview. And if you're lucky, you'll get a little plug.
Yeah, we'll definitely mention your name and your company name. So this is going to be a big plug. So yeah, go for it.
Also, Andy's going to be hosting our first ever official meetup in New York. It will be September 17th. We don't know the time or the place yet. We'll also announce it on Instagram. We may know the location by our next episode, but do keep an eye on our Instagram. That's at Wedding Biz Show, and we will keep you updated.
I love this idea, Melissa, of having a meetup in New York, because it's really an incredible chance for all of us to get together and meet like-minded people, right? I mean, if we're all listening to the podcast and into being educated and inspired, then certainly it's going to be a great chance to network and meet other fans of the show who are like-minded, again, in the sense of wanting to, you know, take your businesses to that next level. And so I would love to meet each and every one of you. So if you're in New York City, if you live there, or if you're going to be around on September 17th, yeah, definitely follow us on Instagram at Wedding Biz Show. And Melissa will give the information when we have it. And before I announce today's guest, I do want to take a moment to really thank all of you for supporting our community by tuning into this show, not only The Next Level, but the regular one as well. Because as rewarding as it is to have a career in this industry of weddings and events, obviously, it's just extremely challenging too. And so again, I love that we get to support each other. And my purpose for creating this show is to educate and inspire by sharing these in-depth and personal conversations with such icons of the business. So, and these people have been through it all of it, like all the wonderful times, but all the struggles that we all go through. They've been through it. They still go through it. They talk about it. And so we want to continue to spread the word and help others. So we want to ask Melissa and I, if each of you could commit to sharing this episode or a previous one that was meaningful to you with even just one single friend in the industry, we could help build this community and share. So we would love it if you can share with a friend or colleague. So today's guests are really something else. We're talking about Abby Larson and Tate Larson, founders of Style Me Pretty. Abby is the original founder of the wildly popular online wedding resource. Abby and her husband grew it to one of the largest reaches in the industry, and as many of you know, sold it to AOL in 2012. Abby stayed on for a few more years and then left to take a year off, spend with her children. Tate was working with startups and worked as an entrepreneur in residence at Northeastern University at, oh gosh, I don't know how to say this, the Barabasi Lab. I hope I said that right, Tate. And after this incredible outcry from the industry when AOL announced that it was going to close, Abby and Tate eventually took it back. This is a big story. I was so excited to fly to Boston and visit with them in their home and to dig real deep into how they each grew up and to hear the details about how they built such an incredibly successful business. And Abby and Tate are so humble. They were so vulnerable. They were so revealing in this interview. So I highly recommend that if you haven't heard it yet, that you do go back and listen to the entire interview. It is off the chain. So, Melissa, what would be a first topic that really grabbed your attention through this conversation?
Well, before we get into topics, I just want to say on a personal note, at Engage in Banff recently, I got to sit across from Tate and had a fantastic conversation with him. And I've been jonesing for this interview to come out because I could talk to him all day. And when you guys listen to this interview, really, really feel like you were sitting right there in their living room with them. So excellent job on the interview, Andy, because it really felt the same, you know, as when I was having that conversation with him. So I really loved that. But also Abby was on stage at Engage, and there is so much more to the story than, you know, her time would allow. So I really like that we got to dig into it more with them and learn more about them. I've been a fan of Style Me Pretty forever. So I really loved this. For topics, my first favorite thing really stuck out when I heard Abby say how she learned everything not to do in a business. And one of the things that I loved was, you know, when she was beginning her stationery business, she would look around and see what everyone else was doing. And she saw that all of her peers were doing, you know, X, Y, and Z, and she really wanted to find ways to do something bigger and different and more creative. And I think that that really was the lifeblood of what Style Me Pretty was when it started. And I think it really is the lifeblood of where it is now. And so many of us can relate to that in our businesses, don't you think?
I agree, Melissa. I'm really glad you brought that up. She learned what not to do in business. And, you know, in terms of creating her own rules, she made a point that she and Tate felt you don't have to mimic what you see our industry friends or industry competitors doing. And she was saying because the world was changing so fast. That was interesting that she also threw that in. So I really loved that. It's really talking about having the courage and the guts to, in a sense, ignore what everyone else is doing and give it more effort and give it more thought. I remember for me in my music business, I remember when I first came to town and I started it, people were dressing a certain way. They were performing in a certain way. There was a certain style of music. And right away, I was thinking to myself, wait a minute, why can't it be more like a celebrity act at a wedding? But of course, not this big show. I just was like, I don't want to dress that way. And I want to do a certain thing with the music. I want to have a certain presentation on stage. And I just went for it. And, you know, at the time, it didn't really feel courageous, you know, but you look back and you think about it. And again, especially the way Abby put it in context, think outside the box. But I love that she was really supporting that you don't have to do what you see even your friends doing, what anyone else is doing, no matter how successful or not it looks, you can still do your own thing.
You know, when you look at where you started in your business and where Abby started in her business and what everyone was doing and how, you know, back then, I'm sure it felt like a lot of comparing was going on. And it's even worse now, you know, where you look at what everybody's doing on Instagram and what everybody just posted on Facebook. And it becomes a game of comparison. And as much as I'm a fan of social media, I really think that there has to be a way for all of us to feel authentic about it, but also get ingenious about how we're putting ourselves out there. And I love that that's what you're doing with the podcast too. You know, I mean, I know that's a little bit of a plug, but I like that it's a fun new medium that you've taken advantage of. It's so cool.
No, I appreciate you saying that, Melissa. And also, I would say connected to that is kind of even another topic that Abby and Tate talked a lot about, which was that nowadays, we've got to make everything more meaningful. You know, you could have a million beautiful pictures and you know, there are a lot of companies out there, they're showing all of that. But it's getting to the point where there's so much out there. What about going more beneath the surface? And yeah, that is the points about this podcast, is that I didn't want to do the kind of surface, what are the top 10 tips? And with all these people that we're talking to, we want to go deeper. We want to find out what is really meaningful to them and how did that tie into their creativity? And it's so interesting to hear that. And Abby and Tate are giving so much thought to it. Because let me put this in context about Style Me Pretty. You know, again, we all know, I think by the time AOL closed it, they were up to 18 million page views per month. There were something like 36,000 photographs. The numbers were enormous. And in the interview, Abby and Tate talk about how it turns out that, yeah, you got to have the numbers. But on the other hand, still, what does that really mean? Like you talked a little earlier, Melissa, about social media. Does it really matter what number of Instagram followers we have? I would say no, not really. I think that's a distraction and we get anxious about it. It's not about the number of followers. It's the people that are really paying attention. Are you really telling your story? And part of their mission that they specifically said, and that's what they're still working on to figure out, is how can they help, as they called it, vendors, we like to call it partners, how can they help the vendors, all of you out there, tell your story about how hard it is to execute these amazing parties and the level of experience that it takes. You know, with all the photos, it's hard to really discern when there's so many beautiful ones. How do we go deeper to tell that story?
When you look at all of these things, like the blogs, like Instagram, like Facebook, Pinterest, all these opportunities, they're tools for us to be able to communicate. And one of the things that Abby did in the very beginning of Style Me Pretty was she reached out to people and she created a community. That she had that fantastic list of fabulous talents. And those people were the ones that supported her then in the beginning. But they're also the foundation of the support at this next stage where their work was so inspiring and it was so everywhere. People didn't want to let it go. And it had such a major impact because that was surrounded by community. It wasn't just that a bunch of businesses wanted Style Me Pretty to stay around because, you know, their portfolios were there. It was so much bigger. She even talks about how parents of brides that had been published wanted them to stay and what could they do? And that is the power of community. So when you look at all these amazing tools that we have online. Yes, you know, numbers are fun to count. It's fun to make sure you're getting ROI on your purpose, but don't get so caught up on that. Really take a cue from her and focus on building community around your business, around what you're doing, and using those tools to communicate with them. I think we try to do a pretty good job with that too.
And tied into that too, I mean, I remember Abby saying this really grabbed my attention. She said, how do we gauge our success? She asked on the mic, are you doing the kind of work you want to do every day? Are your clients paying enough? Are you charging enough for that? Are you expressing your value enough? And what makes an impact is not others saying how great you are, but rather, I loved this. Are you thriving every day? And are you still having fun? I thought that was really something. She was bringing it back to that as well.
Somebody said something to me recently that was really powerful that is totally on along the same lines here is we are in a creative industry, but just because we are in a creative industry doesn't mean that it always is going to make us happy. And so we really have to make sure that we don't just have a job, that we're not just getting up and answering emails because that's what we are supposed to do. It really, really needs to feed your soul. And that is what's going to continue, you know, making our clients happy and our businesses thrive. But it's bigger than that. It's about us being able to thrive, you know, and she talked about how she wanted to be a really hands-on mom. And that's one of the things that really fueled her decision to sell. And I don't know that you necessarily have to go that far, but I think we do need to keep that goal of fueling our personal passion fire going, you know?
Yeah, I love what you're saying, Melissa. And before we close, I want to suggest to everybody that in order to come up with something that's really new, the way you're doing your business, the way you're messaging your brand, and also, again, what Abby suggested that we all think about, which is, are we thriving every day? Are we still enjoying ourselves? And she talked about if you are focusing on having a blast doing what you love and you're pushing yourself creatively in that sense, the rest follows suit. And yes, obviously we got to have business plans and we think about all that part of it, but I love the gist of this. And so I want to encourage all of you, we have to take time every day. I was talking with Melissa before I hit the record button about we're all so busy right now. And yet I start my day, you know, I do some stretching, I actually do meditation, and then I work out in some way, no matter how busy I am. And Melissa, you were talking about the ways in which you make time for yourself as well. And we must, whether it's the beginning of the day or giving yourself a long enough lunch where you're actually eating and not doing work while you're eating, you know, and then finding a way at the end of the day to have some kind of a slowdown before you go to sleep. And I think if we give ourselves more of that space, then we are going to have the creative inspiration inspiration to have these ideas. So again, I want to encourage everyone. I know we're working so hard and so fast, and this is the season right now, but we've got to make time for ourselves.
We all love serving our clients. And I think that for so many of us, that's what is our motivator. And that's how things can become out of control. But I really think what you're saying is important. And we really have to stick to our boundaries there. And sometimes we forget that we actually have to educate our clients on our boundaries. And that's been a really powerful thing for me, is just sort of teaching them how we work so that they're not expecting you to answer an email within 5 seconds. You know, that is one of the most powerful little tools that I've found. So hopefully that helps.
Yeah, I love that about creating boundaries. Well, that's all the time that we have for today. Again, we want to thank everyone so much for listening and supporting the show. It really does mean a lot to us.
If you guys go to our website, which is theweddingbiz.com, there is a pop-up. There's also a little form on the website itself on the right-hand side. Pop your email into there and we will send you the next level guide. And if you are an Instagram lover like me, I also have a link for that in our Instagram, which is at @weddingbizshow. If you click our link in our profile, it will pop right up and you can sign up right there without ever leaving Instagram. We also have a lot more coming, so I really suggest you guys stay tuned.
Oh yeah. We have some announcements. We got a lot of, like, we already announced the network that we launched, thewedding.com with Julie Sabatino. We've got some other people. We have some huge announcements coming up. So definitely sign up for the email list. Follow us on Instagram. Also, I want to mention next week, we are going to be releasing my second interview with Preston Bailey. That's right. Preston Bailey part 2. I went to his office in New York City. He is so gracious. I want to say we got deep. I mean, I already get deep in these interviews, but the second one, we really went there. So be sure to tune in next week. Don't forget to go to the website and go to Instagram so that you can ask a question of Brian Raffinelli. Melissa's going to pick one, and I'm going to mention your name and your company name. I'm going to ask Brian your question if you're picked, so go for it. Thank you so much. Be sure to share with someone who you care about, and we will talk to you next week.